why can't we open one?
I asked for a teddy bear. I really hope that's what is in here.
You know, kids, we have to wait to open our gifts. I think we've forgotten why we get gifts in the first place. I know what we can do to remember why we give gifts. Let's read the story about Jesus' birth. It's right here in the first chapter of Luke in the Bible. It goes, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God
to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a girl named Mary. She was engaged to be married to Joseph, a descendant of King David. The angel Gabriel appeared to her and said,
"Greetings, the Lord is with you."
Confused and worried, Mary tried to think what the angel could mean.
"Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and his kingdom will never end."
Mary asked the angel,
"But how can this be?"
"The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God."
Thank you.
were shepherds staying in fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
Suddenly, the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying,
Thank you. Where's the one who's been born the King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east.
We have come to worship him.
The star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy.
He has scattered the proud upon you. He shows He has brought down princes from their thrones and exalted the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away with empty hands. He has helped his servant Israel and remembered to be merciful. For he made this promise to our ancestors, to Abraham and his children forever.
Praise the Lord, the God of Israel, because he has visited and redeemed his people. He has sent us a mighty Savior of his royal line and his servant David, just as he promised to his holy prophets long ago, because the God sent them mercy.
The morning light from heaven is about to break upon us, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide us to the path of peace.
What an amazing story. We should read it every year.
Yes, Lord, it is an amazing story.
I get it. It's not about me and all my presents. It's about Jesus.
Yeah, I'm sorry that we've only been thinking about all these gifts.
I hope you always remember that God gives us the greatest gift of all in Jesus.
There are people who are in hungry countries that are fighting and people who are sick. So how can we share our gifts with others?
How can we share God's love?
And our time. We could hand out some blessing bags or volunteer our time and help those who are in need.
We can pray for peace.
Thank you. also want to give a huge thanks to our church school leaders that come every Sunday and Wednesday and give up their time and their talents. Can we give them a round of applause? And I want to thank you, parents, grandparents, friends, for bringing your children here, for teaching them Bible stories, for sharing God's love. They are lights in the world, and as we heard, we need a message of peace in the world today, and they are doing really, really good things because of you. So thank you for what you are doing, and I want to thank all of you. This would have been a pretty boring program if it was just the band and me up here, so thank you for being a part of this program. Can we give them another round of applause? After this, we are going to sing one last song and dismiss all the kids to the gym. We do need a parent or grandparent or guardian to pick up every child in the gym before they are able to go to the reception. We have some cookies and treats out here after. But again, a parent or guardian must pick up the children in the gym. And also, if there is anyone as we're socializing, again, as I said, there's lots happening here, and we need to get the risers down. So if there are any people who are stronger than I am that would like to stick around for just a couple minutes, it won't take long, right after this, and help us get the risers down so we can get the altar ready for worship the rest of the week, that would be great. So pass it over to Pastor Dan.
Well, before we worship God for gifts of tithes and offerings, I just want to lift up a big, one more big thank you to Julie Wilson, our team. I don't think you quite understand. Julie would get to the peace on earth, and she could hardly hold it together. She's been so in love with this opportunity and your kids and the gift that they all are. So thank you for sharing them with us. But we want to say thank you for being here today and all the ways that you are the hands and feet of Jesus. Because it's not just here that we share that good news. It's needed out there. And so we know we're not number one of the ones who actually form the faith for our kids. It's moms and dads and grandmas and grandmas. And then pastors and teachers are way down the list. So thank you for the ways you are sharing God's love with them. That makes all the difference in the world. Every dollar you give today is going to help us help all know the Good Shepherd. That's our mission. That's everything that we do here. And so we're thankful if you've been coming here for years, and we're thankful if you are brand new. You know, over this last year, we have over 70 new kids that have joined us and their families up for church school on Sundays and Wednesday nights. And they have been a gift for us, you know, they are for you. So thank you for joining us in that mission. So as we do that, we are going to turn your attention to the screens. There's a video about invitation and about good news. We'd love for you to watch that as we take this time to worship God.
Dear Jesus, we write this letter for which you have been accepted today.
Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness!
Hannah, you gotta see this. Look at this.
Okay. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Start from the beginning.
Plus everything.
Okay. So.
You gotta be kidding me. It's great. Hey, come here. You gotta listen to the story.
I have something to show you. Oh my goodness.
Dad! Dad!
First.
We gotta tell him how this happened.
Thank you.
was great. God, thank you so much for the gift of your good news, of you sending your son, because you not only love those shepherds, you loved us enough. You love the world enough, those who had no voice. And so God, as these kids, as these gifts have given us your good news today, we worship you. We celebrate with them, and we pray, God, that you can inspire us to go out this week to be the good news and to look out for those that have no voice, that need your hope, that need your forgiveness, that need your life. So God, help us to be your hands and feet and carry that message to those around us. In your holy name we pray.
Right, we're going to stand up, we're going to sing Joy to the World, and you're going to sing it as loud as you've ever sung it before.
Thanks be to God.